What do you hope we come away with in reading this collection? A love affair with architecture?
Oh, I always hope for that.
An understanding of its significance?
I think you might come away with more understanding now with the perspective and in retrospect of what happened in the 20th century, which was a revolutionary period for architecture. And I didn't realize till I sat down to put these pieces together that I'd been a witness of this and that I had recorded it in so many of these pieces. So it was really marvelous to do this book because it told a story, and a story that when you're a journalist, whether it's your work or my work, you're of the moment, you're of the crisis, you're of whatever matters now. So it took this book to make me see what I had really been a witness to.
Why was it a revolution?
Well, first you started with modernism, which was a revolution, which began really, let's say, at the turn of the 20th century, and then, you know, worked up ahead of steam in the teens and the 20s and the 30s. By the 50s, you were already having a quiet reaction against modernism, leading up to postmodernism, so that you have revolution and counter-revolution both in the 20th century. And then out of postmodernism, which I found a good cleansing of the air, but a pretty silly movement in architecture, out of that you got a new creativity because all the doors were reopened that modernism had closed. The doors to history, the door to ornament, the door to your own senses, that architecture could be as sensuous as it is intellectual.
What was the defining postmodern building?
The AT&T
building. That's what I thought, with
Chippendale
at the top.
Yes, it's a dreadful building.
Yeah, but that was it.
Well, it said it all.
Philip again.
Yeah, absolutely. He was a catalyst that we miss terribly now.
Yeah. When you set out to collect these, what was the criterion for what you include in a book that's some 465 pages?
Well, there was an awful lot of stuff to go through. And as I started to go through, really feeling rather hopeless about it, I realized that things were falling into a pattern.
A coherent narrative.
A coherent narrative. And that some things that were terribly important or seemed important at the time really didn't matter anymore. You know, the cause was over, the moment was lost. And so I picked pieces, many of them, that I had not put into other collections because it told a different story.
When you looked at all the pieces, what surprised you? Was it the narrative that there was a kind of connection?
That didn't surprise me. It pleased me very much. What surprised me was that they stood up. They weren't dated.
And you didn't revise any of them?
I didn't touch them. Not a word is changed, not a note
But that's
made.
A tribute to you, that they stood the test of
it's
time.
It's a tribute to me as a historian. I'm trained as an architectural historian. And I think these pieces should accurately reflect the time in which they were written. And if you start to fool around with them and make notes and use your hindsight to change them, you're denying that. And I found that they did stand up that way.
Join us online at charlierose.com.